Welcome to this week's Business Roundup. My name is Viola Oksasia, and with me tonight is Paul Busharizi. He's a business journalist with a New Vision, and he'll be answering some of our questions arising from the biggest business events that happened this week. Thank you for joining us. So Paul, welcome to the interview. Let's start off with the most recent report by URSB says that there's been a drop in registration of companies. Actually, the drop is in the number of companies registered, meaning that people are not coming forward to register. So there is a drop, a very sharp one, between 2021 and 2022 of about 30,000 companies, actually. So what do you think is the cause of this? Are people not coming forward to register, or are businesses actually not starting at all in Uganda?
First of all, I think that I suspect, I don't have any firm data on it, that apart from the economy of stalling, not doing as well as it should, I suspect also people are just not registering their companies. They're doing business without registering, which is worrying, because what we need is more formalization of our economy. And them doing business without registering means, one, they are limited. Growth is going to be limited because they can't do certain businesses. They can't do business, for example, with government. It's just out of the question, and with many companies. And two, it limits their growth because there are certain things you need to have to grow that you can only get after registration. So, for example, if you're going to get a loan, you could get a loan as a personal loan, but it's limited how much you can get as an individual compared to a company, among other things. So it's a worry.
And the Ministry of Finance still projects 6.5 percentage growth in the economy. So where is that? How come we do not see that? Could you please explain that in our layman's language?
No, I'm sure the economy, the incentive to get into business is less now than maybe it was 5 years ago, but the people who would do business, because many times they do business because they can't get jobs, they will not lie down and die. They will still do business. Now, the problem is they're going to do it informally. So my only worry is that we want to shift the economy to be more formal, but I'm not worried that people are not making money. I think people are still going to start their businesses and do whatever it takes to stay alive.
Interesting. And finally, Paul, talk to us about the latest update from the Karuma power dam.
Yeah, it's kind of exciting news about Karuma. They've been testing the first turbine. So Karuma is a 600 megawatt dam, and it's supposed to have six turbines, each of 100 megawatts. So they've been testing the first turbine. And on Wednesday, they put 40 megawatts on the line, on the grid. So we're seeing light at the end of the tunnel. Ideally, it should mean that we'll have more stable power. And it could be, by the way, part of the increase in the per capita GDP, economic growth, that we'll be exporting this power and stuff. What?
Speaking about economic growth for Uganda, we saw the president meeting with a delegation from Germany, and they had a discussion about possible investments in Uganda. We also saw that the forces of the two countries are talking about getting together in medication, especially for tropical diseases. But what other areas can Uganda benefit from when it comes to relations with Germany?
Yeah, I think, obviously, I mean, if German businessmen are coming here, Germans are known for in the mechanical industry, machinery and auto and cars and pharmaceuticals, which is interesting. The Germans are also big in pharmaceuticals and electronics stuff. There's a lot of stuff that we can do. The challenge is for Uganda is to attract businessmen, they need to see the market. Now, you can come and say we're East African, but we've seen our challenges with our East African people. You know, guys blocking our roads, shutting our borders or blocking our products. So for anyone to come to Uganda, he has to be assured that it's not only 45 million, but the whole 300 million of the East African community. And that's going to be the challenge for us, regardless of who comes, whether it's the Germans or the Americans or stuff like that. Potentially, we have a huge market, but there are a lot of barriers to entry, especially crossing to borders. So that would be our challenge, selling it to the Germans, wherever we want.
All right, thank you so much for making time for this week's Business Roundup. We'll see you on Friday next week. And dear viewer, thank you so much once again for making time to watch. We shall talk to you again next week. Stay up to date with the latest business events on the Business Roundup. I'm Viola Xasira, back to the news.